As discussion continues to define possible offshore wind areas along central California that are suitable for future development, the multi-agency Offshore Working Group, led by U.S. Representative Salud Carbajal's office, has identified areas off the coast that may be compatible with Department of Defense training and testing activities. The working group wants to know what the public and stakeholders think about these areas, starting at 15, 17, and 20 miles from shore. Several of these areas are closer to the coast than areas currently considered by the Bureau of Ocean Energy Management. This brief presentation features a number of photographic simulations that represent a hypothetical offshore wind project in these new areas and how it might appear from various points and distances from the central coast of California. These simulations were prepared by the environmental services firm ESS Group. ESS Group is a professional environmental services company with deep expertise in coastal engineering and renewable energy systems integration. This presentation will discuss the simulation objectives and provide a general overview of wind energy development and the selection of locations to produce the simulations from, which are called a key observation point, or KOP. Working from four designated KOPs along the central coast, we'll discuss the photographic work done in the field at those locations, the three-dimensional simulation process performed back in the office, the photo panorama development using pictures taken at each KOP, and creation of the finished product. Finally, we will take a look at 12 selected finished simulations which show the turbine development from different locations, lighting conditions, elevations, distances, and times of day. The visual simulations featured in this presentation illustrate hypothetical projects. The simulations represent a 1,000 megawatt project using hypothetical 15 megawatt turbines that are 889 feet in height, which is about 100 feet taller than the Golden Gate Bridge at 746 feet tall. The National Renewable Energy Lab provided the physical dimensions of these hypothetical turbines for this simulation project, which are not in production yet, but are reasonable estimates of future technology that could be deployed in California. The turbines in an offshore wind farm are arranged to optimize the capture of wind energy. As turbine blades rotate, they produce electricity, which is sent through a transmission line to a substation. The substation collects energy from all the turbines and then transmits that power to shore through a transmission cable where it then connects to the onshore electric grid. On this map, areas currently considered for possible offshore wind development by the Bureau of Ocean Energy Management are shown in gray. Four key observation points were chosen to provide representative viewpoints for the areas identified by the Offshore Working Group, shown on this map as north and south areas, delineated in blue and green. A discussion area is also shown, outlined in red. The first key observation point is at Julia Pfeiffer Burns State Park in Big Sur, which was simulated at a point along Tin House Road. The second KOP was on the Pitkins Curve Trail Overlook off Highway 1 at Lime Kiln State Park in Big Sur. The third KOP was near the historic Piedras Blancas Lighthouse in San Simeon, also off Highway 1. The final KOP is at the summit of Valencia Peak in Montaña de Oro State Park, Los Osos. KOPs were selected by staff from California and federal agencies because they are known for their popularity, have a broad range of different elevations, and are representative of other areas along the coast. The map shown here includes these four KOPs and their locations along the central coast of California, an indication of the different simulated distances from shore, especially 15 miles, which is the yellow line, and 20 miles, the green line, as well as other important geographic influences on sighting and visibility. In May 2019 and February 2020, an ESS field crew captured site photography at these key observation points using a high-resolution 50mm digital camera and supporting photographic and geospatial equipment. The crew selected each photography site based on its accessibility, visual exposure to the area of interest, and the prominence of landscape elements that would provide a specific sense of place for each simulation. The camera was set up with attention to recreating the ocean view as seen by a typical visitor to each KOP. The photography team carefully recorded the camera's position and view bearing using GPS and physical measurements. Weather and lighting conditions were also recorded, in addition to date and time, to accurately match conditions between the baseline photography and the simulation environment. An evaluation of the prevailing meteorological conditions experienced in this area was also performed using 10 years' worth of local data. Those interested in more information on the meteorological conditions on the Central Coast can view the report on the Bureau of Ocean Energy Management's California webpage. The simulated wind turbine array was created using physical specifications of the turbines and predetermined placement of each turbine within the wind farm area. An Earth curvature model based on viewing distances developed by ESS Group in previous consultation with Dr. Jackson Cothran from the University of Arkansas's Center for Advanced Spatial Technologies was used to calculate the appropriate elevation for each turbine. Since turbine nacelles rotate around the monopole relative to wind direction, prevailing wind direction is factored into the simulation and turbine blades are randomly rotated around the nacelle to simulate realistic conditions. Photographic panoramas were created for each KOP to cover a field of view 124 degrees horizontally by 55 degrees vertically, which is consistent with typical human vision. A series of overlapping photos were taken using exposure bracketing, which produces three variations of the lighting conditions for each shot, and then stitched together to construct a panorama. Using photo editing software, the photo panorama is combined with the rendered simulation of the turbine layout. After the two layers are combined, any rendered elements that fall below the horizon are removed. If the panorama is intended to represent a time of day different from what was photographed, the position of the sun at that alternate time is determined and used to manually adjust tone, contrast, brightness, and shadow effects consistent with that time. Simulating conditions at night represents an extreme case of altering the daytime lighting and is accomplished by using multiple layers of semi-transparent gray gradients and desaturated versions of the color panorama, which are then combined with a render of the lights from the modeled turbine layout. The simulated turbine lighting is based on Federal Aviation Administration guidelines and is specific to turbines of this height. The aim of the simulation project is to understand the potential visual impacts of a hypothetical wind farm when seen from a number of different locations along the Central California coast, under different lighting conditions, times of day, and distances from shore. For each of the four KOPs, simulations were produced for 9 a.m., 1 p.m., 5 p.m., and 10 p.m. at distances of 15, 17, and 20 miles from shore. While a total of 48 individual simulations were produced, this presentation focuses on 12, which have been selected as offering a representative comparison of the different distances, sites, lighting, and elevations that might be used to view such a hypothetical wind farm. While this presentation strives to provide an experience that is as close as possible to how these turbines would look in the real world, the fact that this video can be viewed on a number of different devices and mediums, each with their own characteristics, means that the viewer must accept a degree of compromise. For example, someone using a 10-inch tablet to view these simulations will have a very different viewing experience than someone using a 30-inch computer monitor or a 60-inch paper plot of the same thing. Located on the California Central Coast, 40 miles south of Monterey in the town of Big Sur, Julia Pfeiffer Burns State Park is a popular destination for nature lovers who come to enjoy its trails, forests, and ocean vistas. These viewing simulations are from a viewing location on Tin House Road at an elevation of 912 feet. Viewing conditions are good with mostly clear skies, a slight haze on the water and at the horizon, and the 9 a.m. sun behind the viewer and shining on the turbines, which are front lit. The majority of the turbines can be seen in the center and just to the left of center within each view. With each distance, the viewer may notice a small lateral shift of the turbines, which is due to the slight change in perspective as the turbines are positioned progressively further from shore. 15 miles south of Julia Pfeiffer Burns State Park on California's Big Sur coast is another popular destination, Limekiln State Park. The photography for these simulations was taken at 5 p.m. on the park's Pitkin's Curve Trail Overlook, elevation 595 feet, and shows the turbines under very different lighting conditions than the morning simulations at Julia Pfeiffer Burns State Park. With these late afternoon simulations, the sky is overcast with variable and thick cloud cover. The lighting changes with the clouds, and the turbines are lit primarily from the side and slightly behind, but with a more diffused light due to the variable atmospheric conditions. While the majority of the turbines can be seen in the center of the view, they visually shift slightly to the left as the wind farm is simulated progressively further offshore. 50 miles south of Lime Kiln State Park is Point Piedras Blancas and its light station, which was built in 1875 and is listed as a California Coastal National Monument. These simulations, taken along the coast immediately south of the light station and at an elevation of 31 feet, represent a simulated 10 p.m. nighttime view of the 889-foot-tall turbines. With these simulations, the viewer can get a sense for the visual impacts of the turbine lighting based on applicable Federal Aviation Administration guidelines, including those for turbines taller than 699 feet, which are required to have two lights on each turbine's nacelle and three on the tower. When viewed at these lower elevations, the viewer can expect a more complex visual environment, including interference by ridges, trees, sea stacks, and the lighthouse itself. The white light to the right of the simulation is the lighthouse tower light. In each of the three simulated distances, the majority of the turbine lights can be seen in the center of view between the sea stack on the left and the lighthouse itself on the right, but then continuing further to the right, partially visible over Point Piedras Blancas until being obscured by the land. Just south of Morro Bay in the town of Los Osos is the popular Montaña de Oro State Park and its coastal mountain, Valencia Peak. This final set of simulations represents a midday view of the turbines as seen from the 1,344-foot summit of Valencia Peak. With the nearest simulation, 15 miles offshore, the turbines appear in the center and just to the left of Spooner's Cove, visible along the coast in the middle of the picture. With the 17 and 20-mile simulations, the turbines shift progressively to the left. Photography for these simulations was captured during clear conditions at 1 p.m. The foreground lighting is strong and clear, primarily overhead with a slight haze in the distance at lower elevations and clouds forming on the horizon and starting to move inland. For additional information on the visual simulations, please visit the BOEM website at www.boem.gov/California or contact Jean Thurston Keller at jean.thurston-keller@boem.gov. To view this video, see the additional simulations, or comment or access the CEC docket, go to https://www.boem.gov/regions/pacific-ocs-region/march-9-2020. And thank you for viewing these simulations.